Thanks for tuning in to this tutorial on creating web-accessible Word documents in Microsoft Word. This video is geared towards all APS employees creating documents for posting on the web and for distributing across the district. So, let's get started on exploring the common issues you will encounter and the steps you will need to take for creating a document that can be viewed and understood by all. It just so happens that every file you open using Office 365 or Word 2016 for Mac includes an accessibility checker that you can run to find any errors in your document. For Windows, you can find the tool here in the File tab by choosing Info, Check for Issues, and lastly, Check Accessibility. In Word for Mac, just click on the Review tab and then select Check Accessibility. A panel will open to the right of the document and either say No Accessibility Issues Found or an outline of the errors, warnings, and tips for you to fix. Now that you know where this mighty tool is, let's focus on some of the issues that the accessibility checker will and won't find and how to remedy them. Let's take a look at headings first. Using headings is pretty important in providing structure to your document, so you want to make sure to use the heading formatting tools in Word rather than increasing font size or bolding text. Also, using headings in a logical order from 1 to 2 to 3 will make it easy for screen readers to tab and navigate through the document. Lists. We all love them, but if they're not built correctly using the formatting tools in Word, the accessibility checker will find you. So go ahead and get cozy with your formatting toolbar to build a bulleted or numbered list that will identify order and hierarchy in your document. Avoid using symbols like stars and check marks, as they don't get translated to those using screen readers. Along with lists, tables are used quite frequently in documents we create at APS. Tables are only to be used for data, not for graphic layout. You would want to use another program for that. As mentioned earlier for lists, use the formatting tools especially meant for creating tables. Format tables to include a header row and a column by clicking on the top of the cell to locate the Table Design tab off of your toolbar. Ensure the header row checkbox is selected. Moving on, let's dive into images. Images are super fun, and adding some color for yours and others' delight isn't a crime. However, you will be prompted by the accessibility checker to give it a text title and description if there isn't one. Adding alternative text to your images is a major help for those who have any visual impairment. So each image, graph, table, or shape requires a word or two about what it is for context and understanding, like napping kittens or skipping dinosaurs. Lastly, let's explore the world of properly inserting links. Who knew there was such a thing? Yep, using text to describe where the link will take the user is important. For example, instead of using Learn More or Click Here, use Visit Our School Library. The link text should be meaningful and make sense. If you must write out the web address, be sure to also add where it will take the user. For example, visit our Albuquerque Public Schools District website, www.aps.edu. The accessibility checker is a big help for those things like headings, lists, tables, and images, but it does have some limitations. A couple limitations include fonts and color contrast. Please be aware that certain fonts reduce readability, like Comic Sans and Bradley Hand. Stick to fonts like Arial, Helvetica, or Calibri. Those fonts maintain their integrity when used with screen magnifiers that zoom into text. Tempting as it is, using different types of font colors for text and backgrounds can render your document unreadable. Creativity need not fall to the wayside, but you must use high contrasting colors. For example, yellow on white or blue on purple is hard for anyone to read, but for someone with dyslexia, it could pose as a real barrier to accessing information. And using red to indicate urgency will be completely missed by someone who is colorblind. So, after you've made all the corrections, you can save your Word document in Word or as a PDF, which will maintain the accessibility features. Hooray! You've done it, and we couldn't be prouder. Now that you know the ins and outs of making a Word document accessible for the web, you can go forth and share your document with the world. In fact, have a biscochito on us. However, if you get stuck and need a helping hand, the web team is never too far and will gladly walk you through the process. Just contact us by using the Git Web Help form, and we will be happy to assist you. Who knows, maybe we'll all learn something new in our quest to become web content accessibility experts. Thank you for helping APS in setting the standard for accessible web content. Together, we can ensure that everyone can access and use our content. That's all for this tutorial. Check back often for even more tutorials regarding web content accessibility.